Let's start the next topic for this session. We are accustomed with what is dividends all about, what the various factors which affect a dividend policy. Let us see what are the various types of dividend policy now. Which policy does a company keeps into account when it starts paying dividend? See, it depends upon the company, and industry to industry, we have various types of a dividend policy. A company can either have a regular dividend policy, stable dividend policy, irregular dividend policy, or no dividend policy. Now, let us cover one by one each one of them. Now, what is regular dividend policy? Regular dividend policy is the payment of dividend as the usual rate. I'll pay you a regular dividend, means whatever happens in my company, at least you'll get some dividend every year at the usual rate. So, not like senior citizens, pensioner, this class of investors are happy. At least every year they are getting some return from your company as such. Whatever happens, I'll give you regular flow in the return as such. That is a regular dividend policy. Next type of dividend policy which a company can follow is a stable dividend policy. Stable dividend policy is what? At least I assure there's a minimum amount of dividend which I'll pay you regularly. The stable means I say this much amount you'll get every year as such. 8%, 6%. I'm specifying today how much dividend you'll get every year. Now this stable dividend policy company can do in any form. Either a company can say I'll pay you constant dividend per share. I'll do constant payout ratio. A stable rupee dividend plus extra dividend. Now constant dividend per share, for example, I tell you whatever happens in my company, at least I'll pay you 2 rupee per share dividend. That is constant dividend per share. Or I can do constant payout ratio. Whatever happens, I at least pay you 50% as dividend. Profits are 80 lakh, 40 lakh, 10 lakh, 5 lakh. Out of whatever profits we get at the end, at least we'll get 50% as payout ratio. Company can do in that way, depending how much earnings they get. Or they can go one way, stable rupee dividend plus extra dividend. For example, we'll give you minimum return in the form of 2 rupee per share, 3 rupee per share. But if a company does extra good, we'll pay you extra dividend as well. So you're happy, minimum you're going to get every year as well. This is one form of dividend policy which a company can form, it is stable dividend policy. Or a company can go for irregular dividend policy. Now, companies which are facing financial constraints of earnings and unsuccessful business operations mostly follow this irregular dividend policy. Now, it is one of the temporary arrangements you can say companies make with the shareholders, right, to tackle their financial problems. For example, a new company, they may say we need some money to stand on our feet. So what do you say? We'll give you some years, for 1 or 2 years you get dividend, then you don't get dividend for another 2-3 years, then again you get dividend when a company is self-sufficient. So this is what irregular. Company pays you dividend when it feels it is to be given, when they're in a position to give you back. That is an irregular dividend policy. And the last we have is a no dividend policy. Company does not pay dividend at all to its shareholders because of unfavorable working capital position. Now, because they want money for their future growth, for example, a new startup company, for getting a profit only will take so much time, right? So, reach a break-even point will only take so much time. So, company for that time follows a no dividend policy. The various types of dividend policy which a company can follow time to time based on the shareholders and based on what are their objectives in mind.